Hey, what's up? Welcome back to another quick Flutter tutorial where we create functional apps from scratch. In this one, I'm going to show you how to code this coffee app that I made, where the user can browse through different coffees for sale and add them to the cart, which of course the user can also remove items from the cart, and finally leading us to this payment button. And as we do this, let's try to make the UI design to be minimal and a clean aesthetic, which is sort of my style. So let me show you how to make this by jumping into the code. So I've opened up a brand new Flutter project, so you should just get this Flutter demo counter app. Now the first thing I'm going to do is to prepare some images you might need. So I've got these four coffees that I just got on the internet. You can go to any icon website. I recommend maybe flaticons.com. But once you got those images, let's go to your project and go to the library, and we're going to drag the images in here. Cool, so let's come back to our code and go to your pubspec YAML, because we have to tell it that we're going to import some assets. Okay, so we have it in library/images, and let's save it and close this file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create this completely from scratch. So let's delete everything below the main function, and I'm going to create this from scratch. So for the material app and the home, let's start with a home page. And I'm going to create a new folder called pages, just to keep our code nice and organized. Cool, so for the home page, let's just make sure to import it in our main.dart file. And for the background color, so let's make it gray 300. Now, by the way, one good practice to do is to make a const file for constants. So I'm going to make the background color variable here so that it kind of reflects in the entire app. Okay, so if I come back to my home page, let's just say background color. So if I need to make any changes to this background color, I can just do that in this const file. Sweet. Now the first thing I'm going to do is let's just start off with a bottom navigation bar. We can use the default Flutter bottom nav bar, but I'm going to import the Google one because I think this one looks pretty modern. Now I made a separate tutorial for the Google nav bar, so check that out if you need, but I can show you real quick how to do it. So if you look at the scaffold, this bottom navigation bar is what we want to fill out. Now just to keep our code nice and clean, let's do this in a separate folder called components. Okay, so let's create a stateless widget, call it my bottom navbar. Okay, and then if you start typing gnav, you can see there it is. So press tab to auto import, and we have to fill out these tabs, okay, which is a children of Google buttons. Okay, so the first one, I'm just going to make it a home icon, and the text, let's say it's the shop. And let's create one more button, kind of like a shopping bag for the cart. So if I come back to my home page, we can start to fill this out now. And if you save this, you can see there it is in the bottom. Cool, so let's decorate this up. So for the color, I want to make the unselected color a bit more gray. And when there's only two options here, I like to just make the axis alignment to be centered. Okay, and so from here, you can really decorate it up to your preference. But if you like my aesthetic, you can just copy what we do here. So I'm going to include a border, so the tab border, and let's just make this white. So you can see that there's a little border there. So yeah, I think this looks pretty good. Now let's just wrap this in a container, and maybe we could just give it some spacing. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Awesome. Now that was just the decoration part of it. The functionality part of the bottom navbar is this on tab changed. So you can see if I tap on each of these, we need to have a method. So let's require this when we create it and just pass through the method here. So the value, it will tell us about the index on the bottom navbar. So if you come back to the home page, right, you can see it's got a red squiggle because we have to specify this on tab change. And the P0, so this is just the index integer. Okay, so if I tap the bottom navbar, let's navigate to a different screen. Okay, so let's create this method up top. So first of all, let's create an integer to know what the selected index is. So right now, let's just say it's 0, which is the shop. And then Let's create our method here. So with a given index, let's update our selected index. Cool. And then let's display the appropriate pages. Okay, so we're just gonna have two pages, the shop page and the cart page. Now we haven't created these yet, so let's do that now. So what I'm gonna do is just to create a stateful widget, and let's just put in the center, just a text widget, just so that we can see if this is working or not. Cool, so come back to the homepage and import these bad boys. In the body of the scaffold, you can now give it the pages with the selected index. So if you look at our app, we can now, you can see if I click around, it reflects the appropriate pages. Awesome, awesome. So what that means is now it's time to create our shop. So I'm going to create a new folder called models, and models is basically the sort of data structure and the kind of object oriented programming that we're going to do. So what I mean is, let's first of all create a coffee, right? How are we going to represent a coffee? So we need a few things. I need to know the coffee's name, price, and also the image. Do the constructors for these. And I'm going to need to create one more model, which is the shop. Let's create this class here. And I'm just going to comment a sort of plan. So at the beginning, we need to know the coffees that are for sale. Have a method to get the coffee list. And we also need another list for the user cart, and also an ability to get the user cart. Maybe we'll put the getters on the bottom side. Cool. And the main two important functionalities are adding item to the cart and also removing from the cart. Okay, so let's start to fill this out. So starting with the coffee. So I'm going to create a big list here, a big list of coffees. And let's call it shop. And we have four different coffees that I'm going to make here. So let's say black coffee, latte, espresso, and an iced coffee. This is just the example I'm going to use with the images that I chose. So let's create our coffees here. Okay, so there's our long black, and let's just copy these and change up the values. So make sure that in the images, the naming is exactly the way the string is. Awesome. And now let's go to the user cart. So this will also be another list of coffees, but this one is just going to be an empty list at the beginning because it'll be empty. Cool. Now in the different parts of our project, we want to be able to get these lists. So let's create a little getter method. Okay, so if we get the coffee shop, just return the coffee shop. And same thing for the user cart. Cool, so now that we set up the shop, we have to fill out these last two methods, which is adding the item to the cart. So let's create this method. Now, if I'm going to add an item to the cart, I'm going to need to know which coffee was added. So I'm going to include that as a parameter, and then we can just add it to the list of carts. Similarly to the remove, we need to know what coffee it is and then just remove it from the cart. That's how easy it is. Cool, cool, cool. Okay, we're making some good progress. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is let's come back to the shop page and let's try to display all of the coffees in the shop. Right, so I'm gonna replace this with a big column and let's have a bit of a heading here. How would you like your coffee? Now it looks like it's scrunched up at the top and we can't really see it. So let's wrap this entire thing in a widget called safe area, which just helps us avoid the notch kind of area. So yep, let's do that and also add some padding. Cool. So this is our heading and then we've just got a little bit of space. The main thing here is the list of coffees. So because we are in a column, let's just use an expanded widget to fill up the rest of the space in the column. And we're going to return a list view. So we're going to get the individual coffees and then return the tile for each coffee. Now, I just realized, for us to access our coffee shop, we're going to need a sort of simple state management solution dealing with different screens and stuff like that. So I'm going to use a provider package, which is probably the most simple state management that there is. So just import this one. And I've used provider in my previous few apps, like the grocery app and sneaker shop and stuff like that. So if you don't know how to use it, I can just show you real quick to set it up. So firstly, in the coffee shop, we need to extend it to the change notifier. And in the main.dart file, we've got to wrap this entire app in a change notifier provider. And for the create, we need to give it the coffee shop. Okay, and the builder, we just give it our material app. Sweet, so this change notifier, basically what it does is if there's any changes to our app, like for example, the user adds items to the cart and removes them, we want to reflect the state of the app, right? So anytime that any changes happened, we need to notify the listener. So the only two things we need to notify are the adding item to the cart and removing item to the cart. So that's the only sort of UI state changes that is going to be made. Cool. And then what we can do is we can wrap all of this in a consumer widget so that we can consume this data. Okay, so make sure to give it the coffee shop. And if you have a look at this value is how we access everything. So if I try to get the individual coffee now, you can see if I say value dot, and now we have access to all of those methods that we created in our coffee shop, right? So first of all, getting the individual coffee, let's get the coffee shop and just go through each index. Cool, and then let's just return a basic list tile just so that we can see this working. And just return the coffee name. Cool, and the very last thing is the item count. So let's get the coffee shop length and just print that many. Cool, and there it is, there's our shop. So now that we've got that, we can now spend some time to sort of decorate this. Okay, now I could make this coffee tile, fill it up here, but I want to make my code clean. So let's create a new component called coffee tile. And just with a given coffee, let's create a kind of more prettier tile. So in the title, let's have the name. Subtitle, let's have the price. And the leading, let's have the image. Okay, so let's return our coffee tile now. And if you give it the coffee, then you can see everything's reflected. It's looking good. Now coming back to this coffee tile container, I want to make this sort of more colored. And I think we're going to need some margins here. Maybe just on the bottom though. Cool. And corners are looking very sharp. Let's border radius this guy. And maybe we could use some padding as well. Everything's looking kind of squashed. So on the top and bottom side, let's put 25, and maybe horizontal, let's put 10. Let's actually fill out this trailing and give it an icon. So this one is going to be, let's just put an add button so that the user can add it to their cart. Right, so you can see this onPressed function. Let's copy it and make sure to require it. And coming back to our coffee tile, you can see now it's got a red squiggle because we have to fill out this onPressed. Right, so if I press this plus button, then I want to add it to the cart. So void add to cart, now I'm going to need to know which coffee I'm going to add. So let's give it the coffee. And then now we just need to use a provider to access those coffee shop methods. Right, so you can see here, add item to coffee and just give it the coffee. Sweet. So yeah, you can see that plus button now. And when we add it to the cart, I want it to be reflected in the cart page, right? So let's come back to our cart page and let's fill this guy out now. Cool, so kind of similar to the shop page. So overall column, and let's just have a little heading at the top. Cool, and then below that, let's have an expanded list. And we're going to return a similar tile. Now, I could create a new cart tile, but what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to reuse my coffee tile because it's going to be very similar. Now, the only difference is the fact that I want to change the plus sign to a delete sign. So you see this add icon, we kind of hard coded this in. So instead, let's just also vary up the icon. Okay, so what this means is if you come back to the home page, or the shop page rather, the coffee tile, now you have to fill out the icon. Okay, so I'm gonna, of course, for this one, I should give it what we had before. And now we can just reuse this coffee tile. Okay, so let's get the individual coffees, which again, we need that value. So let's wrap this in the consumer. Cool, and now we can get each coffee from the value and go on through the user cart. Now we can return the coffee tile. So let's give it the coffee and on pressed. If I press this, then I want to delete. So let's call it remove from cart. And this icon is a delete icon. Ooh, which reminds me actually, the previous one should actually be a plus. Yeah, like an add icon. Cool, so now let's have a remove cart item. Okay, and let's just call that provider method. Okay, everything's looking good, except for the fact that we have an error because I didn't specify the item count. Okay, let's see if this works. So here's my list of coffees, and if I add it, then you can see we have a long black. And now we can remove it from the cart. Cool, so I can add multiple coffees and I can remove them. Now, one thing just from using this app currently is, as a user, I feel like we should have some feedback to know if the user successfully added the coffee to the cart. Okay, so what I mean is like, when we add the coffee to the cart, yeah, for sure it got added, but let's also let the user know that it's been done successfully. Okay, so let's just show a quick dialogue. Okay, and just give them a nice little message here. So let's try this again. So click plus and there's our little dialogue. And yeah, so it gives us as a user a lot of feedback and feels like, you know, everything's working well under the hood. Cool, everything's looking so good. So what we can do now is just maybe create a little pay button at the bottom. So below this list of cart items, let's just create a pay button. And if I press this button, then we need to pay. So let's create that method up here. And in this pay now method, this is where you should fill out your payment services here. So that's going to depend on your app and your business. Now let's give this pay button a bit of a brown color. Ooh, looks like our text should be white then. Cool, and then border radius, let's make it more circular. Oh yeah, the decoration should be above the child. And we can wrap this in a gesture detector, and on the onTap, we can now fill out and do the pay now method. So like I said, this pay now method is where you can kind of integrate your payment services, whether it's Stripe or, you know, whatever it is. So we started from scratch and we made some pretty damn good progress so far. Now, I developed this app much further by adding like a nice intro splash screen and also just kind of cleaned up a lot of different parts of the code. I added a drawer as well. And I also added this sort of quantity screen where you can select the size and the number of coffees you want. And so, yeah, there's a lot of things to fill out from this point on. And if you're interested in the further developed coffee app, then you can get it from my Gumroad below. But hopefully this tutorial was helpful and you learned something. If you have any questions, just let me know below. I'll try to come around and help you out. But thanks for watching and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.